Good morning. Thank you for joining us for another Monday Word of Encouragement. This week, we want to encourage you to confess. To confess to the Lord everything and anything that's hurting, the anxiety, depression, mind battles. Those battles that we go through every day, because we know that those pesky demons like to play mind tricks on us, like to keep us down. But when you confess in the name of Jesus, those demons flee.
Amen.
So we need to continue to confess our ills, our hurts to our Lord, day in and day out. Confess to the Lord and proclaim your healing, because this is what the Word of God says.
In Romans chapter 10, verse 8 through 10, the Word of God says, "But what does it say? The word is near you. It is in your mouth and in your heart. That is, the message concerning faith that we proclaim. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved."
Amen.
It is with your mouth that you profess. So just like the scripture says, you profess you're saved, then you are saved, because you're confessing out loud that you believe in Jesus and you believe that he was raised from the dead. It just goes for everything else. That's why it's so important for us to be in our word every day, whether it's a chapter, a scripture, a day, whatever it, however much time that you have, just to be in your word and confess his truth over yourself. So if you're sick in body, every day when you wake up, after of course being thankful for even waking up, you declare it. Declare, "I declare that I am healed by his stripes in the name of Jesus Christ." If you're afraid, "I will not be afraid because of my Lord Jesus Christ." If you have anxiety, if you're sad all the time, if you're mad all the time, declare that he is enough, that he is sufficient, that he will bring you the joy that you need in your life.
That's right.
Whatever it is, but we encourage you to confess the word of God over yourself, no matter what it is. There's power in confessing it, just like the scripture talked about it. If you confess, if you haven't, that's a great way to start. If you have not declared that Jesus is the Lord and Savior of your life, we can do it together right now, right?
Yeah.
We encourage you. Say this small prayer. "Dear Jesus, I believe that you died on the cross for my sins and that you resurrected after the third day. I ask you to forgive me of my sins, the ones that I know of and the ones that I don't. And help me live a life that is pleasing to you. In Jesus' name, amen."
Amen.
As simple as that. I'm confessing and I am declaring my salvation. We know that the day we die and we leave this earth, our names are written in the book of life. We declare it, we confess it, and that brings so much joy to our heart, just to know. So we encourage you to say that prayer and have your name written in the book of life as well, because I know that if they ask us, "Do you know where you're going when you leave this earth?" We say, "Yes, we do. We're going to go into eternity with our Lord Jesus Christ."
Amen.
So we pray that all of you make it there. But like my husband was saying, confess the word of God over your situation every single day. And just trust him in the waiting. Amen?
Amen. And if you did say that prayer, we want to welcome you into the family of Christ. And just continue to seek Christ in yes. everything that you do in life.
Yes.
Thank you again for joining us. Be blessed. We'll see you next time. Buenos días y gracias por acompañarnos para otro lunes de ánimo. Esta semana, el ánimo que le queremos dar a ustedes es que confiesen todo a nuestro Jesús. Que confiesen al Señor todo lo que se sienten mal, los pensamientos, la depresión, la ansiedad que a veces nos da. Porque nosotros sabemos que confesando todo al Señor, Él nos ayuda, en su nombre. Él nos ayuda, porque sabe que a veces que esos demonios a veces que juegan con nuestros pensamientos, pero ellos también se alejan de uno cuando usamos el nombre de Jesús para protegernos y para levantar a Él todo para su gloria.
Amén.
Pero también tenemos que acordarnos que confesando la palabra, Él siempre está con nosotros, porque la palabra de Dios dice
en Romanos capítulo 10, la palabra de Dios dice: si confiesas con tu boca que Jesús es el Señor y crees en tu corazón que Dios lo levantó de entre los muertos, serás salvo. Amén.
Amén.
Esa escritura tiene mucho poder y, como dice en la palabra de Dios, si confiesas, si crees con tu corazón que eres salvo, serás salvo, porque estás declarando que tú crees en Jesús y que fue resucitado después del tercer día. Así es para cualquier situación que estés pasando. Si estás enfermo, declara que por la sangre de Jesús sobre tu cuerpo todos los días hasta que Él decida sanarte. Y esperar, pero esperar y tener fe en Él. Y saber, es bueno saber el poder que tiene confesar y declarar la palabra de Dios.
So, acuérdense, esta semana, sea lo que tengan, lo que estén pasando, confiésenle al Señor. Pídanle con todo corazón que les ayude, que esté con ustedes. Y sigan orando por ustedes mismos, por sus familias, sus amigos. Y vamos a seguir echándole ánimo cada semana y siguiendo a seguir a nuestro Jesús.
Y si nunca han confesado, podemos hacerlo hoy. Es una simple oración. Es buena forma de empezar el camino de fe con Jesús. Es una oración muy simple, como dice aquí en Romanos. Y si la quiere decir con nosotros, lo hacemos ahorita juntos. Y solamente tenemos que decir: querido Jesús, perdónanos de nuestros pecados, de los que sabemos y los que no sabemos. Creemos que fuiste crucificado en la cruz y que resucitaste en el tercer día. Ayúdame a vivir una vida que tú estés en ella, en el nombre de Jesús. Amén.
Amén.
Es muy simple, pero el poder está en confesarlo. Amén.
Amén. Si ustedes hicieron esa oración ahorita, les quiero dar como los quiero invitar y agradecerles por eso, y bienvenidos a la familia de Jesús. Que Dios me los bendiga. Tengan una semana bendecida.